Hi everyone, I'm Elodie Bousbib. I'm currently a postdoc with Asier Marceau at UPNALAB at the University of Pamplona in Spain. Today I'll be presenting FlexiVol, a volumetric display with an elastic diffuser to enable reach-through interaction on behalf of all my co-authors. This work was founded by the ERC interval and the touchless grant agreement. So first thing first, what's a volumetric display? Well, it's a device that forms a visual representation of an object in three physical dimensions, in true 3D. It is autostereoscopic and provides a different view to each eye, thus creating a true 3D content without forcing users to wear a headset or glasses. But here, we're going to talk about a type of volumetric displays. Swept volumetric displays. Well, it contains a physical volume in which the 3D object will be perceived, but more generally, it contains a diffuser on which the projection occurs, springs connected to voice calls or speakers creating an oscillation, and a projector. It then literally sweeps the diffuser really fast so that the surface is non-perceivable by leveraging the persistence of vision to make perceive an object without perceiving the diffuser. So we can see on this video that the diffuser starts moving really fast and we perceive a true 3D rabbit. But how does it work? Actually, the actuators follow a sinusoid, which is synchronized with the projector, slicing the 3D objects into bit planes. Each slice appears along the sinusoid and represents a cut section of the 3D object. Altogether, they render the full object. So thanks to a high-speed video capture, we can see here the rabbit appearing as slices, and when the sweeping occurs, each of the bit plane being projected at a different height. At a high speed, with persistence of vision, we find the rabbit again. So volumetric displays are great to render true 3D objects, but how do we interact with them? Well, we might want to put our hands within the volume. However, we do have a fast-moving surface, causing a safety hazard. Usually, volumetric displays have a safety dome around their display volume so that the user can touch it in a safely manner. The interaction can be then pointing into the volume or by tracking the hands with the camera and replicating the movement with an avatar, or more classically, through a 3D mouse. So basically, everything we can do consists in indirect interaction. But because we like to put our hands in, the research question of this project is, how to enable direct interaction within swept volumetric display. So here we refer to direct interaction as per Hillegas' definition in Holodesk, allowing the user to literally get their hands into the virtual display and to directly interact with a spatially aligned 3D virtual world. So we propose FlexiVol, a novel concept of using elastic diffusers for a volumetric display to enable reach through direct interaction. So first, what properties should the elastic diffusers have? We studied mechanical, optical, and oscillatory properties. Elastic diffusers show different properties when put through oscillation and displacement, different amplitudes, resonances, deformation. So we pre-selected six materials, three different types of elastin, silicone, elastic bands, and finally a classic projection screen fabric. First, we experimentally characterized the sample stiffness using a load cell attached to a 3D printer. But as some samples got fatigued, we then characterized their hysteresis and whether they suffer plastic deformation, whether deformation is reversible or not, as per the elasticity here. Therefore, we deformed all our samples longitudinally and measured their tension twice. For clarity purposes, we only display here the elastic bands and classic projection screen. So we can see that the deformation is almost linear when being stretched. However, when being relaxed, the projection screen follows another curve. This shows that the elastic band does not suffer from hysteresis nor plastic deformation, while the projection screen actually does. Then we also characterize the optical properties of our sample with a grid pattern, RGB stripes, and a white light while being stretched and relaxed. So let's look at the white light. So we see here that the silicone reflects it and that the elastic bands show dark lines around the seams. So we decided to measure the RGB average intensities over this spread as a function of the offset angle from the central projection axis. So we know that, for instance, for the silicone, the average intensity is saturated at the center due to the reflection of the light. But for the rest of the samples, results are quite constant, and more especially, the elastic band's dark lines do not seem to impact the RGB intensities with results similar to the traditional projection screen. Finally, we characterized the frequency responses. We placed our samples between two speakers and increased their frequency up to resonance. We synchronized a strobe light to enable the capture of the oscillation at a regular frame rate and observe the amplitude and dynamics of the strips. So after characterizing the samples, we define our guidelines as the diffuser should be soft, nonetheless, its deformation should remain elastic. Its optical diffusion should not provide any distortion nor blur to the image. And its resonance should be different from the system's resonance frequency to avoid large amplitudes provoking graphic distortions. So we selected elastic bands, but more details are available in the paper. So now let's focus on the second part of FlexiVol. What interaction techniques can we perform with FlexiVol? First, a user can swipe into the display volume or touch to select. A user can also scale an object using a menu or pitch it in and out and can rotate object. He can also push onto the strips to edit, let's say, a landscape and navigate performing alternate swiping. More actions can be performed, such as tracing, twisting, squeezing, zooming, and gestures can be done with one or more hand, one or more fingers, one or more users. Interaction can also occur with the strip or between the strips in the lateral, longitudinal, or diagonal direction without obstructions of fingers getting stuck between strips. So we provided a non-exhaustive list of direct interaction using FlexiVol as a combination of actions and gestures. Now, to validate FlexiVol's concept, we conducted a user study to verify. Are reach through interaction techniques more efficient than more traditional input modalities? So we chose to compare our techniques with a 3D mouse, which is the traditional input modality in volumetric display. So we gathered both quantitative and qualitative feedback. The study was split into three tasks. First, selection, where users had to select spheres of different sizes. Second, a tracing task, where they had to follow five circuits. And third, a docking task, where they had to fill small cubes into bigger ones. So first, for the selection task, we noted a significant effect on completion time using the reach-through modality. However, in the tracing task, no effect was noted. And as we can see on this animation of user tracing one of the circuits, the position deviation using reach-through modality was, however, significantly enhanced. Finally, in the docking task, we noted a classic compromise as reach-through was significantly faster, while the 3D mouse was significantly more accurate. Finally, when analyzing the NASA TLX per dimension, the mental domain was significantly higher with the 3D mouse as per the temporal domain. Effort, frustration, performance were also perceived as worsened with the mouse. More globally, the reach-through modality was significantly less cognitively demanding than the 3D mouse. Regarding qualitative feedback, more than half the participants spontaneously mentioned that it was easier and more natural to interact with the fingers, and participants felt more confident in both completion time and accuracy using reach-through. When asked about their reaction when they were told they would interact with the display, interestingly, all participants mentioned a sentence with a "but it did not," showing their apprehension, but how they were nicely surprised with FlexiVol's softness. We hence empirically validated FlexiVol concept and demonstrated the benefits of direct interaction in volumetric displays. We envision different direction in future works. Mainly, we plan to couple FlexiVol with haptic technologies, for instance, focused ultrasound, which can travel through fabric and create a focused tactile stimuli on the fingertip. Also, by sewing a conductive thread through the fabric, electrotactile feedback or sparks could be provided to stimulate the fingertip at interaction. To sum up, the contribution of this work are a novel concept of using elastic diffusers for volumetric displays, guidelines for characterizing and selecting elastic diffusers for volumetric displays, a compatible design space for reach-through interaction techniques, and empirical results of completion time, accuracy, and mental workload validating reach-through interaction in volumetric displays. More details are available in our paper on my or UPNA Lab's website, and thank you for your attention.